circle. And you're going to keep his shoulders to the inside of the circle. Now, we do this exercise a lot, and I'm going to try to do it on this two-year-old that's never done it before, but it's going to look similar to this right here. Oh, hey, look at you. Look at you. It's going to look similar to that, but out of the older guys, I don't want so much bend. Similar to that right there. Yeah, similar. But yours aren't going to carry so much bend, and I want their hips more. That's actually pretty good out here, too. And then we're going to stop, and we're going to turn them into the circle that we had just turned.
Can you say that again?
So, imagine that there's two circles in the middle of this pit, like this and one like this. We want his shoulders to stay on the inside of the one circle and his nose to stay in the middle of the circle. And his hip is going to move around the big circle. You get what I mean? So, what I'm going to do is, essentially it's going to be this right here, but at a trot, where his nose stays on the inside of the circle, and his hip moves around the big circle, and his shoulders make a smaller circle. And then I'm going to stop him when he gets it right, I'm going to stop him and I'm going to turn him to the right. And what this does is this drives their, what will become their pivot foot, which is right now the right hock, deeper underneath them. Deeper under that cinch. Well, sorry, I got the trot on the foot. He says, what do you mean? I'm going to work on putting his nose in the center of the circle and moving his hip to the outside of the circle. And he's like, did this one way. There you go, a little closer. Yep. Closer. Not so close anymore. Closer. There you go. Good enough for my two-year-old. And then I'm going to turn into, and I'm just going to let it turn.